what I think is so cool about this exhibit is the sort of recreation of Nancy Noël's studio. These are blown up images from her studio as it was. This, as it was really earlier this year. This is how it looked. This is where she painted for several decades. She was working on at least 10 paintings at a time. So what you're seeing is sort of inside her head. She would paint a little on something, go to another painting, paint that. Sometimes things would sit around for a year or two before she put her final signature on them. Other things, you know, were done quickly. It just depended on how she was feeling and how she was inspired at the time. Mm-hmm. This is actually her paint cart from her studio, her chair and her easel.
So I think the paint cart she's had her entire career.
Yeah.
And the props that you see over there with the rocking horse and the quilt, you are actually featured in the paintings around here.
Right. Yeah. So this, I think, is a very cool feature of this exhibition. I haven't seen this before in another art exhibition of any kind, the sort of studio recreation. Nancy Noël had a relationship with the Children's Museum since the 80s. This was a collaboration she did with them for the Raggedy Ann doll and then Tea Time at the Children's Museum. And of course, she has near the carousel in the other part of the museum, a huge painting that is more recent.
Pink Lemonade.
Yeah, Pink Lemonade, yeah. Some child portraits here. She liked to often paint children together, to see them together. Was sort of a motif that she kept going back to. One of her more spiritual paintings, the dove in all her paintings represents peace. So if you see a dove, it sort of denotes a peacefulness to the subject. This is interesting because this was a very early painting. Michael and I have actually never seen this before. It was in the Hoosier Salon many years ago. It's from 1972. It's owned by the Howard County Public Library, so that's where it's been for a long time. But one of my personal favorite paintings in the show. This is
portrait of me.
Portrait of Michael.
Clearly the best one she's ever done. She painted both Alex and I. I was apparently more patient when being painted.
Yes, he would sit for paintings. Another Hoosier Salon painting from years ago, sent from Connecticut. This is actually me. Story behind this is that I did not like to sit for my mother to do portraits. She wouldn't even be able to take my picture because I wouldn't have it. So this is pretty much the only angle she could get on me with my back turned to her. But it actually turned out to be a pretty good painting. And so it means a lot to me because it's one of the only portraits of me that actually exists, even though you don't see my face.
You got a few. I think how she came, I think what she did here was very creative. This is called The Messenger. This is an Indian elephant. And when she was painting this, she wanted to, you know, she felt that the painting needed something. She had this little angel pendant, and very small, maybe in 1 inch by 1/2 inch, and she said, well, this would look great on the elephant's forehead, and blew it up and painted this. This is one of her, this was done in the last, what, 5-10 years?
Something? Yeah, and this is called The Messenger, favorites. And it's about female empowerment and the matriarchal power, if you know about elephant societies. They have matriarchs. So mother was sort of fascinated with elephants and the symbolism when it came to femininity. This we've had over our fireplace for pretty much all of our lives. This was one of my mother's early call it Americana paintings, and it was something she never wanted to sell. And Michael and I grew up with that in our house. It's weird, actually, to even see it here. Mother was obsessed with horses. She was a horse person, and this is a model, but she was always painting her own experience, is what Nancy Noël would say. And so her connection with animals just is a recurring theme from her entire career. Children connecting with animals, which is really what my mother wanted to do as a child, was to be around animals, connect with animals, have animals in her home, and she did that. This, I think, is really cool. One of her more recent paintings, more whimsical side of Nancy Noël, one of my personal favorites, and actually a very popular image. It's called A Delicate Balance, as you can see. You might take this for granted that this is kind of a simple painting, but it's actually technically pretty difficult. You really have to know what you're doing to get the proportions right and to kind of make this illusion look good. It's not easy to make this look good. You have to understand perspective and balance as a painter to pull this off and to make that illusion look cool. Of course, one of her more interesting works from Africa, this one is called The Matriarch. It's actually hung in the National Museum for Women in the Arts in Washington, D.C. For a while. This is a woman from the Herero community in South Africa, who she met while traveling there, I believe in the 80s. Velveteen Rabbit, we actually have an antique rabbit here, but Mother was very obsessed with the story of the Velveteen Rabbit. If you don't know it, look it up. It's a really interesting, kind of haunting story about a girl and her rabbit. Mother painted a lot of angels. This one is one of our favorites, and the one that hung actually in the foyer of her house, of our house at Landfair Farm. So one of her absolute favorites. This actually I have in my Brooklyn apartment. It's called Bloom. It was the last of her floral paintings, and in my opinion, one of the best florals that she ever painted.
This is also one of the last ones that we have.
It's the only floral painting we have left in our collection.
Yeah. All of them have sold. This is the only one we have.
One of her early big successes, the antique rocking horse.
And this is the first time you and I have seen the actual original painting.
First time Michael and I have actually seen this. It was painted before Michael was born, and I don't remember it hanging in our home, but it's been owned by a family for many, many years. Image from Africa, Sambu room with the baby. A lot of the African peoples that my mother painted over in Eastern and Southern Africa. She was fascinated with the way that they dressed themselves. They carried children on their back. This is probably the best-selling image of all time.
Sarah.
It's called Sarah. Mother didn't really understand why it was so popular at first, and then later kind of understand it. But there's something about this image that people love. People would always go to this image, and it became her best-selling print of all time. And Diane Meyer Simon was nice enough to send it from California for this exhibition. Waiting to Dance, one of my personal favorites. These are Maasai women, and they're waiting in a line where they're about to do a dance. So I think what's interesting about this is that she's not painting the dance, she's painting the moment before the dance. Mother was always interested in stillness, and I think she gravitated toward that part of that scene playing out in Africa. The Hounds, she painted many dogs over her career, and this is just one of our favorites, and really the only painting we still own from this period in her in her career. Cat on the Quilt, one of her best-selling pieces, really one of the pieces, the images that launched her career. People love this. Still to this day, it is a popular image. A little bit more impressionistic side of Nancy Noël, from her early days in Africa, of a woman washing clothes. But you can see the paint dripping there and how the technique is you know, a little bit different there. And it's just a really cool painting, in my opinion, the color, the depth. A more recent painting, you can see several layers going on there. A difficult technique to pull off, the moth. You can see a skeleton there between the girl and the moth. You can kind of see the eye of the skeleton there, if you notice, in the wing of the moth. So this one is one of her more haunting and ethereal images, and represents some of the ideas that she was more, you know, obsessed with later in life. And there's a lot of other images from this time in her life, but they're just not represented here. You can certainly go online and to the website and see more of those images. But hopefully in further shows, we'll be featuring some more of that stuff. So it's a nice cross-section of curated images here, but there's a whole lot more because, you know, our mother painted every day almost of at least our lives.
Yeah.
And so there's well over 1,000 images that she's painted. So, yeah.